Hello everyone, welcome to the session on parallel external sort merge, which is one of the operation of the parallel sorting techniques in the query processing technique. At the end of this session, you will be able to formulate the steps in parallel external sort merge and you can apply the parallel sorting techniques for a given relation. It means you can, for a given relation, you can apply this sorting technique and you can parallelly sort the things. Now, so this parallel sort, already we have seen earlier also, it applies an intra-operation parallelism. It means one operation is parallelized, okay, for multiple processes, using multiple processes. So here a single operation we are considering as a parallel sort. What is this? This is an intra-query parallelism technique. We have already seen earlier also that inter-query and intra-query are the parallelism techniques for query processing. So this parallel sorting technique, in this one, there are two major sorting techniques. One is called as a range partitioning sort and another one is called as a external sort merge. For the first one, you can refer my earlier video. Now today, we'll see this external sort merge technique. Few assumptions are there before starting this one. The assumptions are, we are considering that we have n number of processors and we have n number of disks. And you can see here that the processors are P0, P1 till Pn minus 1 and disks are D0, D1, Dn minus 1. And a relation is there which we have already partitioned using any of the technique. The relation may be round robin technique or hash partitioning or range partitioning, whatever. So a given relation which we want to sort, that is already partitioned by few partitions. And those partitions we are assuming here as partition R0, R1 till Rn minus 1. What is our objective? Our objective is to sort a relation, a given table R, which is residing on n number of disks on a particular attribute A. What is that attribute? On which attribute you want to sort it? For example, if your relation is employee table and if you want to sort it by salary, then salary will become an attribute. So here that employee relation we are sorting by a salary attribute. So consider now this assumptions are these one. We have processor P0, P1, Pn minus 1 and we have disk D0, D1, Dn minus 1. Our relation is there which is already sorted by some of the technique and that relation has sorted as partition R0, partition R1 or partition Rn minus 1 and here we are applying the parallel external sort merge. Let us see the steps in this. So the first step is sort the relation. Partition Ri, which is stored on disk Di on the sorting attribute of the query. So what we are doing, we are sorting a particular relation already it has, we are considering that already it has partitioned. So on every partition, on every disk, we are applying the sorting. Okay. So every disk is parallelly sorting. Now after the sorting, the second step is identify a range partitioning vector V for this one. So here what we have done, whatever the earlier partition technique is there, whatever the earlier disk contents are there, okay, for them we are applying a sorting technique and after that again we are going to partition it. So for that, on what basis we want to partition? Now in this one, for example, if we are partitioning by salary, then we have to consider our vector based on that salary, based on the processor. So here we are considering P0 to Pn minus 1 processor. So for that, the partition vector we are taking. Now the next one is what? The third step. Each processor is now performing. This is the actual parallel technique which we are applying here. So every processor PI is performing a merging. How it is merging? See, already we have seen that those are sorted. The data is sorted in different disks. Now, for example, consider processor P0. What P0 will do? Every disk partition will take whatever the range of the P0 processors is there, it will send all the records to that one. For example, if a salary range is below 14,000, then all the records in every disk are coming to the processor P0 for that one. Okay. So what we are saying here, the data are actually transferred in order, that is all processors send first partition into P0, then all processors send the second partition into P1 and so on. So based on that. and finally we are concatenating. We will see this by an example. Proper example is given here. Now, so what is our relation? We are considering a relation as employee relation with the three attributes, that is employee ID, employee name and employee salary. Okay. Now, what we want to assume? We are assuming that there are three disks and those are partitioned by round robin technique. D0, D1, D2, these are the disks which we have considered, and along with that the processors are P0, P1 and P2. So, in this what we can say, processor P0 is associated with disk D0. So, whatever the processor P0 is taking, it is working on the contents of the disk which are D0. Now, at processor P0, P1 and P2, the relations are already partitioned. Okay? So, those partitioned, we can say that employee 0, employee 1, employee 2 respectively. What are these partitions? These partitions are the table partition. This is a relation employee. So, this is now partitioned as employee 0, 1, 2. And respectively, what do you mean by this? Employee 0 is stored at D0 and the associated processor is P0. Similarly, it's so on. So, this is our initial database scenario. You can see the scenario here that employee 0 is there, employee 1 and employee 2. This is a relation and already these are partitioned D0, D1, D2. The partitioning is simple round robin partitioning technique is there. So, you can see that the partitions are like this. So, salary, now you can see here that salary is totally divided in all the disks. Okay? There is not any uniformity for the salary attribute. Now, let us apply this query, that is select star from employee order by salary. So, we want to sort a relation by salary. So, we want the sorted relation by the attribute salary. So, here actually the table is earlier partitioned, some other attributes are there like employee ID or whatever. Okay? But we want to partition that by salary. Let us see. So, apply the first step. What is the first step? Sort the data stored in every partition, that is every disk, using the ordering attribute of salary. Whatever the partitions are having the data, those are first sorted. So, what will happen in that? The first means below less salaries will come at the early stage and then the salary will move on. Like this, every disk is containing the sorted order. Okay. So, you can pause the video and observe the change in the data, what the partitions are having. You can see here what is the change in this data. What is the change? Let us see. Here the data is sorted. You can see that the data is sorted here. All partitions are sorted. You can see 5000, 6000 like this, here also and here also. Okay. So, this is the change. This is the change for the after the first step. Let us go for the second step. What is the second step? We are identifying the vector. We have three partitions, so we have to go for three vectors. What are our three vectors? We are considering here that our range 0 is 14,000 and less, range 1 is 14,000 to 24,000, range 2 is 24,001 to more. So, here we are considering that the first disk or first range is having all the data of the employees who are having less salary than 14,000 and the middle one is containing the salary range 14,000 to 24,000 and the third one is containing more than that. So, this is our second step. So, you can see here distribution of employee 0 according to the range vector. What is the range vector? That is, we are saying that the range vectors are less than 14,000, greater than 14,000 to less than 24,000 and then after that more than 24,000. So, you can see here that the contents of this disk are now distributed as here this D0, then this one and as well as this one. Here no contents are there because we don't have any salary more than 24,000 here. Okay? But here we have one salary which is more than 14,000, so we have entered here. Okay? So, that is the next step. What is the third step? Now, the above distribution is executed in all processors parallelly. Okay? So, the same distribution is working parallelly in all the disks and upon receiving the records, the various partitions are again means merging, means P0 will go for the first range, P1 will work for second range and P2 will work on the third range. So, simultaneously all the data are distributed. You can see here. So, what will happen? disk D0, okay, all the contents below 14,000 are coming. Similarly, for disk D1, all the contents which are within the range are coming here, and the, so on. Okay. So, what we can say here that this process is done at all the processors for different operations. You can see here, I have shown only disk 0 contents, where all the records of these one which are in the range less than 14,000 are there. Similarly, it will work for the remaining two. So, parallelly these are working. And so, finally, you can see that the contents are, this is sorted, this is sorted, and this is also sorted, where all these are already have this one. You can see the contents below 14,000 all have come into this disk D0, which is working on processor P0, and here this is processor P1 is working on this, where all the contents within the range 14,000 to 24,000 are coming in this one, and processor P2 is working on this, where the contents from more than 24,000 are moved from this one. You can see here that from the first, second and the third partitions, every contents are moving here. So, finally, our table has now sorted properly, just we have to merge all of them. So, that is what the third merge is, okay, D0 content, D1 content and D2 contents. If we are merging all these one, you can see that the complete data is sorted. This is all about the sorting technique. These are my references.